Okay, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, Mrs. Hatmi and student, and my friend. So in this occasion, I want to presentation about our material. The material is the cooperative learning. So before that, I want to introduce myself. My name is Mari Budi Artama. You can call me Budi. So for Arina, next slide, please. Okay, the first slide, we will discuss about the definition of cooperative learning. So what is the definition of cooperative learning? Cooperative learning is a learning model that prioritizes cooperation between students so that positive interactions are stabilized in solving a problem. According to Slavin, expressed his opinion that cooperative learning refers to variety of teaching method in which students work in small group to help each other in learning subject matter. It is intended that the learning process is not dominated by one person, but each group member has the same obligation and responsibilities in solving group problems. Okay, next. Okay, the next slide. We will discuss about the purpose of cooperative learning. The most important goals of cooperative learning, according to Ibrahim in Joni, including the first one is academic learning outcomes. In learning, cooperative learning is superior in helping students understand difficult concepts and increase the value of students in the learning process. In the learning process, cooperative learning improves student achievement or other important academic tasks. Okay, the second is acceptance of individual differences. Cooperative learning provide opportunities for students from various backgrounds to depend on each other for academic tasks and through the reward structure of cooperative learning, they will learn to respect each other. And the last is social skill development. Teach student the skill to work together and help each other. It is important for student to have social skill because currently many young people are still lacking in social skills. Okay, next. Okay, the third slide, we will discuss about the characteristic of cooperative learning. Roger and David Jones said that not all group work can be considered cooperative learning. For the five elements, the cooperative learning model must be applied. Namely, the first is positive interdependency. To create an effective working group, teachers need to structure a segment in such a way that each member of the group has accomplished their own work so that the others can achieve their goals. Second is personal responsibility. Effective teachers in the cooperative learning model make preparation and arrange assignment in which a way that each group member must carry out their own responsibilities so the next task in the group can be carried out too. The next is face-to-face. In the cooperative learning, each group must be given the opportunity to meet face-to-face and discuss this interaction. Activity will provide learning to perform synergies that benefit all the members. The essence of this synergy to appreciate differences, take advantages of strength and fill in weakness. The next is communication between members. This element requires the learner be equipped with various communication skills because the success of group also depends on the willingness of each member to listen to each other and their ability to express their opinion. The last is group process evaluation. Teachers need to schedule special times for a group to evaluate the group's work process and result of their collaboration so that they can work together more effectively. Okay, next slide, please. Okay, The next slide, we will discuss about the teaching technique in cooperative learning. The first is jungle button. These techniques can be used to overcome barriers to equal opportunity that often characterize group work. In many groups, there are often children who have too dominant and talkative. There are also children who have passive and just give up on their more dominant partner. In the situation like this, equal distribution of responsibilities in the group may be not achieved because the passive is too dependent of his dominant partner. Okay, the next technique is small circle, big circle. This approach can be in number of subjects such as science, social science, religion, mathematics, and language. The learning materials that are most suitable for use with this technique. The next is jigsaw. This approach can also be used in several subjects, such as natural science, social science, mathematics, religion, and languages. This technique is suitable for all grades or levels. In this technique, the teachers pay attention to the scenarios or background experience of the student and help students achieve this schemata so that the lesson material becomes more meaningful. The next is STAT. STAT developed by Robert Slavin and friend and Johns Hopkins University. It's the simple cooperative learning approach. STAT refers to group study, presenting students with the new academic information each week using verbal and next presentation. Instructor number help. This learning technique is a development of number help technique. Make it easier to divide tasks, make it easier for students to learn, carry out their personal responsibilities in the interrelationship with their group colleagues. Okay, next. Okay, the last techniques in the cooperative learning is a picture and picture. Cooperative learning model, this type is used for image media in learning process, namely is installing or sorting into a logical sequence, picture of implementation steps. The first is the teacher conveys the competition to be achieved, presenting material as an introduction. The teacher show a picture of activities to take turns installing or sorting picture to a logical orders, and the teacher ask the reason or rationale for the this. And sequence of picture. So from the reason or sequence of the picture, the teachers begin to install the concept or material in accordance with the competition to be achieved after the give conclusion about the lesson. Okay, there are some advantages of cooperative learning. The first is through cooperative learning, students become more concerned about their friends, and between them will build a positive sense of dependence for their learning process later. So the second is student we are taught with the in cooperative structure will the higher learning outcomes. Okay, the third is cooperative learning increase student sense the acceptance of their friends from the different racial ethnic background. So the last is student who participate in cooperative learning will have higher self-esteem and greater motivation to learn. Okay, next. Okay, there are some disadvantages of cooperative learning. The first one is the teacher is worried there will be chaos in the classroom. This condition can be overcome by the teacher. Condition to the class or learning is done outside the classroom, such as in the mathematics laboratory, hall, or in open place. The second is many students aren't happy when they are asked to cooperate with other students. Students who are diligent feel they have to work more than other students in their group, while students who are less able feel inferior are placed in a group with students who are smarter. The third disadvantage is feeling of anxiety in group members will lose their personal characteristic or an uniqueness because they have to adjust to the group. Personal characteristics do not fit just because of working with other people. In fact, the uniqueness is even stronger with just opposite with other people. Okay, the last disadvantages of cooperative learning is many students fear the work will be not divided equal or equitably, that one person will have to do all the work. In cooperative learning, the division of tasks is even. Each group member must be able to present what he in a group so that the individual accountability. Okay, next. Okay, that's all the explanation about the material cooperative learning. I hope you understand what I explained, and see you next week.
Hello, good morning, my dear student.
Hello, Miss. Good morning.
How are you today, my student?
I'm fine, Miss.
Yeah. Before we start our lesson today, I want to know who is absent today. To the captain of the class, do you know who is absent today?
No one, Miss.
Yeah, good job. So you are really intelligent, smart, and clever. Yeah. To start our meeting today, it's good if we pray first. So today's meeting will go smoothly. And me, Miss Arina, will lead the pray. Pray start. Pray finish. Thank you. So today, we will learn about procedure text. Did you all my students know about this kind of text?
Yes, Miss.
Yes, Miss.
What is that?
Procedure text is a text that explains how to do something in sequence of action.
Yes, that's right. So procedure text is also have some purpose. That is to explain how something can be done, such as direction, recipe, instruction manual, and etc. Next, we move on to the next page, which is this. Now you can see and read this procedure text. I will give you 3 minutes to read this.
Okay, Miss.
Yes, go on.
Thank you, Miss.
You're welcome, my dear. Okay, guys, the time is up. Are you done, guys?
Yes, Miss.
Yes, Miss.
Okay, now can I ask a question to all of you?
Yes, Miss.
So after you read those procedure texts, can you guess what the most suitable procedure are present in the text?
Yes, I can, Miss.
Good job. So what do you think, my dear?
I think they are making a hot mix, Miss.
Yes. So why you think that they making a hot milk?
Because as we can see from the ingredients, text and also the step of the text that say boil the milk, Miss.
Yes, good job, my beloved students. You are right. So as Hoki said, we can conclude that this text is about making a hot milk. The other clue is wait until the milk is boiling. Thank you, Hoki. Next is, I have another procedure text. Yeah, this procedure text is more complicated on this text than the previous text. Yeah, so this procedure text is telling you about how to use a computer. Yeah, when you want to use a computer or operate some computer, you need a material such as a CPU, of course, and then keyboard, internet monitor, mouse, printer is optional, and speaker is also optional. Yeah. The step to operate a computer is first is before plug of powering up the computer systems, make sure that the power cable is connected to the back panel of the CPU and is plugged into the electric socket. And the second step is make sure the video cable is already connected to the monitor and the back of panel of CPU correctly, okay? And the third step is make sure other devices such as mouse and keyboard have connected to the back panel of CPU in the right side, okay? The third step is, the fourth step is when everything is plugged in securely, then press the power button on the CPU is usually located on the front panel of the CPU, I think, yeah. And then the fifth step is the computer will display the Windows logo and display the desktop image, okay? And sixth step is once the desktop image appears, then the computer is ready to operate. And the last but not least step of use computer is the proper way to shut down or turn off the computer system is by clicking on the start button and choosing the turn off computer options, okay? This then will display the options to standby, restart, or turn off the CPU. Click turn off to turn off the computer, of course. So that's the explanation or the procedure of how to use a computer, yeah? You can display this procedure into the real life, because as we know in this pandemic, we have a electronic, yeah? Maybe some of you, or your friends or family doesn't know how to operate or how to use a computer, then you can give this procedure text into your family or your friends. So your friends and family will understand, and you can share this procedure text into your family or your friends. So this text is make your friends and family can understand how to use a computer, and this procedure text is gonna useful for your relations, okay? Procedure is also give you knowledge, yeah? Such as like this, how to use something, how to make something, and how to create something. In procedure text, you also have to make sure all the characteristic of procedure text is in the text, yeah? For example, like numbering, and then like the step, like and then after that, like that, yeah? So you have to do it. So you can make the listener can understand and doesn't feel confused, yeah? Which step is the first and the second and the last. So we can know where is we start and we pause and then we finish to read, yeah? So we doesn't confuse when we read the procedure text, yeah? I hope you can understand, yeah? And I hope you can make a good procedure text, okay? Thank you so much. So next is? Now, I want you to make a group consist of 2 until 3 persons. I want your group members consist of heterogeneous students, and I will give you time 1 minute to choose your own group. Go on.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you finished?
Yes, miss.
Okay, now I have some random pictures here. Now work with your group to make those pictures into the correct procedures. And you have to write your explanation about why you think that those steps are correct. I will give you about 15 minutes to do this. And don't forget to do your assignment by dividing your tasks with your partner so your work is become much easier.
Okay, miss, thank you.
Now you can do it.
Yes, miss.
Okay, are you done? Are you done, guys?
Yes, Miss, I'm ready.
Yes, good job. Now I want you to share the result of your discussion to us. I want group one to be the first presenter. Are you ready?
Yes. Well, hello, I'm from group one, and today I want to tell you all about my prosthetic text that we made, and our prosthetic text is how to make a face mask. Based on the picture, the correct order is the first number 2, and then 1, then 5, and then 3, and then 6, after that 7, and the last is 4. The material is old shirt, rubber, scissor, and my friends will explain the step.
Okay, so the step is to lay an old t-shirt out on a flat surface using a ruler or cloth tape measure. Start the bottom of the shirt and measure up 7 to 8 inches. Place the rectangular piece of fabric on a flat surface, cut up and across. You'll end up with a big rectangle, and this will be the material for your face mask.
Place the remaining material from the t-shirt to the side and fold the material from the bottom to the middle. Then fold the material from the top to the middle and fold it again from the bottom to the middle and the top to the middle. This will be your mask. And then lob a rubber band or larger hair tie around, fold the right side in toward the center, then the left side in toward each end of the fabric about 2 inches in from the center. And then do to your marks, the end of the fabric should meet. Grab the marks by the rubber bands or hair ties and place over your mouth, securing each side by wrapping the band or hair tie around your ears. This should be tight enough to keep the mask in place. I'm done, Miss.
Yes, okay. Thank you so much, Group One. So for the other students, who wants to give a comment or feedback to Group One?
Me, Miss.
Yes, Group Three.
I understand the procedures. The steps are also clear, but I think they forgot to the put number of the step. For example, like first, second, and etc.
Yeah, I agree with Group Three. So my evaluations for Group One, it seems like Group Three, that you forgot to put numbering on your text. Numbering is so important in prosthetic text because the characteristic of prosthetic text is numbering. But overall, you're doing such a really good job. The steps are also clear. I can imagine that I, the person who making the face mask, the word you choose is also understandable. Good job, my dear, for group one. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Miss.
You're welcome, my dear. So sad to say this, but I think the time is gonna finish for today, my dear. Overall, you all already understand about how to make a prosthetic text. Can decide which the first step until the last step. Good job, my dear all students. So I want to ask if there are any questions.
No, Miss, thank you.
Yeah, okay, you're welcome. Thank you, my students. I think we can end today's meeting because we start the meeting with pray, then we have to end the meeting also with pray. So I will lead the pray, okay? Pray start. Pray finish. Thank you all for joining today's meeting. I'm really happy that you can understand the material that I give. I hope we will meet again in other occasions. Thank you all. Bye.
Thank you, Miss.
Bye.
You're welcome.